we have three different
ways. Yeah.
But in the end,
and if somebody came back and said, look, I'm gonna knock the front end around, I'm not gonna knock, they wouldn't be wrong.
No. Yeah.
If that's what the, you know what, if the end result gets them there. You know, and sometimes when we work with our amateurs, they judge it, what we do is right and wrong. And I don't think we call each other right or wrong. It's just different.
Exactly.
You know, and
get to the same point.
But you know what we're not doing is we're not picking on our horses. We're not chopping, say, hey, don't look over there. Quit that. Said, well, I'm not going to do that. Easy. But we're not chopping. We're not riding them till they mess up. We're holding them so they don't mess up.
Exactly.
We're being the.
You can turn them loose once they're ready for that.
Yeah.
Strong enough for that. They haven't figured it all out yet.
Yeah. Support. But in your fingertips. No, if it pushes leans or they're heavy, it's going to be hard. You know, you're like, well, what do I do if they're pushing? What do I do if they're heavy? What do I do if they want to go fast? I don't know. Stop, back up, start again. But.
A lot of repetition, but and teaching patience. But ideally, our horses have that in the beginning.
Yeah.
That makes
yeah.
their job a lot easier, but it doesn't always work as easy, but hopefully a patient horse.
Yeah. But you know, I tell people, I got two border collies, but they're not show dogs. You know, yeah. I mean, not every horse is a show horse, no matter what their parents were. And I got two border collies that are out of parents that raised $20,000 puppies. But mine are pets, you know. And so, and people understand that, like, you know, even though a horse don't have a litter, that they have one, it doesn't mean it's a pleasure horse.
Yeah.
But the.
Everyone's going to
be different.
Exactly.
But it's, if we can enhance the things that their strengths are, we'll bring out.
Yeah. And hopefully, you know, it's kind of neat to make a video like this, because now the public sees our horses and they're like, okay, maybe they'll see us at one of the major events and say, I saw that horse when he was loping around with his head.
There you go.
You know, and he was green, you know. And so it's kind of neat. These horses, one of these horses might go on and win something big one day. And you can kind of see how it started out. And it's always good to see how a good horse starts.
Yeah.
And because people beat themselves up too much in the training. And it's supposed
sometimes
to be fun.
Sometimes it's not there, and sometimes it's not your fault. It's you're doing the best you can with what you have.
Right.
It doesn't necessarily mean it's anything you're doing wrong.
Yeah.
You know.
And there's nothing wrong with coming back and trying a horse in 4 or 5 months. Or there's nothing wrong with trying it again next year.
Exactly.
Just don't wear yourself out. If it ain't working and you want to try it 4 or 5 months from now again, and you think that horse is worth that, but that don't mean you got to keep riding it.
I look at it, you know, I get accused of being too patient at times about
horses.
But to me, in any way, it's